Yes, good morning children. In my previous video, we have studied about Rise of Nationalism in India, part 1st. And today we will study about part 2nd, Rise of Nationalism in India. Till my previous video, I told you about the whatsoever Satyagraha has been launched by Mahatma Gandhi. That Gandhi launched that movement. Satyagraha in three different steps, three different areas. You may recognize this picture from closely. Mahatma Gandhi ji was there. And after that, when Gandhi ji declared that Hartal on 6th April 1919, that Hartal, many Satyagrahis were arrested by the Britishers, and they wanted that this movement should be suppressed. And this is the chain of the events throughout this movement, throughout this approximately time period of 100, and most effectively during this 20th century, mean to say 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th decade of this 20th century, from 1910 to 1947, till we attain our democracy, till we attain our freedom struggle. And here I would like to make you clear that when they always series of the event, when Indian tries to do something, they are always pressed by the Britishers. Then also by making different efforts, Indians start raising somewhat and raising some steps against the Britishers. Against the Britishers, they used to suppress them once again. This series of the event was going on continuously for this time period, and once again they passed one this Royal Act 1919. It was passed by British Imperial Legislature. British Imperial Legislature, it has banned all the political activities, people of India, so that ultimately they may not gather at one place. And if they not gather, they will not discuss their policies and do the work accordingly. And the most terrible part of this act was that they can keep in police arrest anyone during these movements without any police remand with 2-year time period. That was really terrible for the movements, for the leaders, for the suppressions. How will they work for this? And under this, Imperial Legislature passed this act to ban the political activity. And simultaneously, Indians were not now lazy, and they were suppressed in this way. They don't want to do anything furthermore. And they were also simultaneously, constantly, deliberately doing their work with the spirit of nationalism. Deliberately, these people kept one. Their Jallianwala Bagh at Shri Amritsar Sahib. They have cut their peaceful meeting on 13th of April 1919 because this was the religious festival over there, and people used to gather. And as a religious festival, they each and every type of community in Punjab used to celebrate it, and they want to discuss some political issue also, but peacefully. But what happened, General Dyer from British Council, General Dyer was appointed to raise a massacre over there in Amritsar during this time period. He took the profit of this opportunity when people from different communities gathered there and they want to celebrate their festival, that is Baisakhi at Amritsar, and they were gathered. And you know what happened, very terrible, that place having very entrance was very narrow, and these people, General Dyer and his force, military forces, did this work over there. And for this, you know that it had very narrow entrance, and four walls are there, boundary walls are there, and it is closed that narrow door, as well as entered there with his force and started shooting the innocent people over there. Whatsoever innocent people were there gathered, that many of them were running. There was a well, historical well, that was filled with dead bodies. They went there, ran there to save their lives. But unfortunately, they got died over there. Many of them start jumping over the walls for boundary of that Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Like on this was very terrible condition over there. People, it was very hard for the people who have gathered there to save their lives. When this much happened there, moreover, it created very much terror among the Indian freedom fighters as well as common citizen of that locality. Whosoever got dead, some jumped over there. Then rest of the people were arrested by the police at that time, and they took them to their police station over there in a flogging way. Flogging way, you know that they are doing like that. Ke on the way they have to walk like a crawling way. They were there crawling from this place to police station. On the way, whenever there are there on the way, there are some police commanders, some their officers, British officers. They have to salute them. They have to salute them over there. For that salution, they have to give them very different type of beats over there. They were beaten brutally throughout the way when they were going from. They were taking these prisoners from Jallianwala Bagh to police station. It created a very terror among the local people as well as the other freedom fighter, and this was the major target of the Britishers, to create a terror among the citizen of India, among the freedom fighter. And this happened here only. There was one question also in previous year question paper. When did Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place? That is, the answer is 13 April 1919. And in this way, simultaneously many more events were also going on. And for these events, one event when all these people were there, Indians were not now some passive. No. They were got more active. Every time whatsoever movement was led by Indians, they took its part very actively in the next part. And this was the major target of Mahatma Gandhi, that they want, all the Indian want as well as he, Mahatma Gandhi wanted, that now we want to launch a mass movement where large number of people will take part in it, not at the upper level, not at the national level. Gandhiji believed that until and unless the masses are not there, we cannot get succeed. And after that, there was the issue of Khilafat. It is also very interesting, as we know that whatsoever happening in the one corner of the world, that whole of the world is getting affected by that. Something like that happened during this time period in Turkey. Name of the country is Turkey, and in this Turkey there was Islamic Khalifa, head of the Khalifa. There, what happened due to that First World War issue was also there. First World War issue was also there. During that World War, this country was got defeated, and due to that defeat, all the Khalifa people, all the Muslims of that particular country, although it is Muslim country, the Muslims of that particular country attacked that Khalifa, so that they were not happy with the programs launched by them. Whatsoever planning was done by the Khalifa, that is the head of their Muslim community. In this way, there were some issues, and as the beginning I told you, whatsoever happening in the one corner of the world, especially in political field, that is affected by, that affects other countries of the world also. And it was the burning topic at that time in India also, that Muslims And Hindus were got divided under the name of Muslim League. Muslim League was established by Ali brothers, Shaukat Ali and Muhammad Ali. And this was two nation theory, because India got divided on the name of religion, that was Hindu and Muslims. And I'm sorry to say here that it was Britishers major target to divide and rule. When they came to India, this was their policy, divide and rule. They wanted to divide Indians and establish their rule here. They wanted to divide Indians and establish their rule here. Somehow, here Gandhiji got scared, because on the name of religion, Hindu and Muslim, they are being getting separated. And this issue once again gave support, fuel to the flame that was already burning in the minds of the Muslims of India. Ultimately it happens, it is human tendency. You may imagine, you may see that agar hum pehle se hamare man mein kisi ke liye something doubtful lag raha hai, 2/3 people aur usko support karte hain, and we are firm about that, it will happen like that only. But here Gandhiji took very intellectual step when Gandhiji door to door went and convinced these Muslims on the name of Khilafat issue. They were this Khilafat movement against their Muslim Khalifa issue that happened in Turkey. They also wanted here their separate nation on the name of their Muslim community. But Gandhiji somewhat convinced them, even got success also for convince them, that let us, Gandhiji convinced on the name, and bring them under the same umbrella of freedom struggle, and convince them by saying that let us make Khilafat against the Britishers. Why among ourselves? And this issue was very much understood by Ali brothers, and they got convinced by Gandhiji, and in this way this Khilafat movement was launched from Indian and came in the name of Indian freedom struggle. Once again I would like to tell you something for its back history, because these Khilafat movement was supported by Britishers also in the beginning, when this was only led by the Muslims, because here their this theory was seems to get success, divide and rule. They wanted that Hindu and Muslim should be get divided and they would be able to rule upon Indians. In this way, in this video I have told you second part, World Tech, Jallianwala Bagh Massacre and Khilafat movement, Turkey issue. Thank you students, take care, stay home, stay safe.